Hello everybody, this is Minecraft Alex here, and welcome to episode 11 of Minecraft Vanilla Superflat Survival. Like I said in episode 10, I was going to do some off-camera work, including generating some cobblestone, and I just decided to generate a bunch more cobble. So this is what... Oh no, that's the wrong chest. So this is what we ended up with. About 18, a bit less than 18 stacks. I don't want to count this, but I think that's a fair approximation. So what I was going to plan to do in this episode is actually make a squid farm. It does sound kind of crazy, but like I said before, I do want to make a squid farm so I can get squids to spawn and so I can get ink sacks. Ink sacks aren't very useful, however... I do want to get them just so I can... I do want to get the ink sacks just so I can have them, because in this series I really want to get everything that is possible to obtain. I'm not going to pick that up because I just don't have enough inventory spaces. So like I said, I just want to obtain every single obtainable item in this Let's Play, and part of that is actually obtaining ink sacks. And to get ink sacks, I'm going to have to build a squid farm. And to get squids to spawn, I have to go up. And this is not high enough for squids to spawn, because they spawn from something like 46 to 63 or like 65 or something. So it does seem quite high. However, I do still need to go higher to spawn squid. So so I would not take up much space. I'm planning to just go out here or something. Let me see. I'm just going to have some stairs right here. And I was thinking at first just going out into a platform and then building a ladder up, but I think that building stairs is a bit better than building ladders, because ladders are more expensive for me, and also just because I have a bunch of I have stairs already crafted, so why not use them? And also, I already have a big ladder right here, so why not make a staircase? So maybe if I have enough cobblestone, I might also make a little barrier here just so I could run up if I ever need to, because this seems a bit too dangerous. So now I'm reading on the wiki right now as I'm speaking that... squids can spawn between Y level 46 and 62 inclusive, so that means the lowest level that squid can spawn is at level 46. Now we're currently at 46, so wow, what a coincidence. Now I'm actually planning to go to level 51 or so, because I will have to have some... my lake will be fairly deep, so that's why I want every block of water inside my lake to be able to spawn squid, so I will have the best rates. So looks like we are already kind of high up. Oh wait, nope. Yeah, that is very high for squids to spawn. And if you think about it, we're actually very low down. Like, in a vanilla world, 51 is actually kind of deep down. That's not even the surface, because the surface in Minecraft is around 63. Actually, the sea level of Minecraft is Y63, so... it looks like we're really high up, but it's just that because the bedrock is so close, there's only... One grass and two blocks of dirt, and then there's already bedrock. So okay, 52. Yes, I think this is where we're going to build our platform here, and I think that we should go a bit farther out, and the reason for this is because I'm planning to pour water down, and if I pour water down there, all of my torches will get flooded, so I will actually, the squid spawning lake will actually be outside the boundary right here. So one thing I forgot to actually take with myself is actually a bucket of water, so then let's just go and grab that real quick. I was actually expecting that we'd have to go much higher. This is not that high up from here, but I'm definitely glad that I did build a ladder here, because I can use this mob grinder as an access for my lake as well. So Like I said before, I'm gonna go and grab one bucket of water, so maybe I'm also gonna go collect some of the drops here, but oh, yay, we got a witch. So I also AFK'd for a while, but I wasn't actually able to I did get more witches and more witch spawns, but I wasn't actually able to, oh, another witch. So like I said before, I actually was able to have, oh, come on, sugar, I really need the redstone. However, sugar is kind of important too. So I actually stayed down here for about 30 minutes in real life, and in that time, I actually did get some, quite a bit of witches to spawn, but unfortunately they only dropped glass bottles and stuff like that, so nothing too important. Yeah, I'm just gonna leave the rest of the stuff because they're not really useful. Let me just collect this one. Carrot right there. I can't wait until we get an semi-automatic farm because I'll be able to clear out all of this space here, so. And I don't like growing food naturally, I like growing it with redstone, innovative designs, so. Let me take a bucket, fill it up. I actually think I'm gonna dump some cobble down here because I don't think I'm gonna need that much. Oh. So, I think that my lake will be 5, oh, actually, one thing that I have to do, oh crap, I completely forgot about that. I have to take 2 water sources just so I can have an infinite water source up there, because otherwise I have to run up and down, so I'd rather have gone up, but it's easier to go down without going up fully than just going, up and down, so, yeah. So I think my lake will be 5 blocks deep, and it, whenever I get more glowstone, or when I go to the Nether and get glowstone from there, I'm gonna add some glowstone to the bottom of the whole lake to light up the bottom as well, and it's just gonna look really awesome. So, one thing that I have to make sure to check is that if I pour the water down here, is it gonna pour? Yup, looks like it will pour down there. So I this is where I'm going to start building my platform, so yep. So I'm going to start building my platform out right here. I actually think that I'm going to have, actually I don't know, I think yes, I'm actually going to also have to make a bunch more cobblestone walls just so I wouldn't fall down. Well, let's just make a crafting table and make some walls right now. I'm gonna need a crafting table anyway, so let's just make some walls. Oh yes, the walls are crafted like this. Let's just make 16 like so. That should yield us about that much. Just break the crafting table here. Oh yes, I don't have any space in my inventory yet. Darn it. Okay, I think I'm just gonna throw down that sword because it was almost fully broken anyway, so. Or should I? Yeah, this is not a very easy task, so. This is the area where I'll have my storage. So let me see. I'll have a crafting table here, a torch here. I'm also gonna make some. I'm also gonna make a chest here because I need a place to store the ink sacks once I acquire them, and also just for general storage purposes. So I'll make a double chest somewhere around here. And now I'll take the cobblestone wall. Now let me see. I'm gonna place a wooden plank here, and wooden planks are my least. Since I have so much wood, I'm not really sad to lose that piece of wood planks because I don't really need it that much anyway, so. So, yeah, let me see. Oh, yes, yeah, so that one I could just shift click. I'm not really sure if I should build the wall down there as well, but I probably should as well. Just also so I should have a place to place the torches, because I'm planning to light this area up too, and I can't really place torches on the stairs, so I'm gonna have to place it like so. Am I still able to? Oh, I'm able to jump up there, so probably should. Okay, I'm gonna go like this, like that, like this, like that, like this, and like that. We're soon going to have a very epic squid farm. I actually haven't built any squid farms so far, because I haven't built any in Skyblock yet. I haven't built any in Superflat, so this will officially be my first squid farm, which is quite epic. So I really hope that we don't run out of cobblestone, because I did spend a long time making the cobble, so that's one thing that I'm gonna look out for. Looks like it's finally done now. Okay, let me just grab some more cobble right over here. I'm not gonna continue this area. Yeah, so this is how it's gonna be. I'm not gonna continue. So yeah, this is, and then the wall's gonna go in like this, and it's gonna continue like that, and this is going to be my storage area. Now, I am also going to put up some more torches around here. I'm not sure if I should put any here, so let's just put some right here. 1, 2, 3. Some right here, just every other. Oh, that's weird. Oh yeah, this one is kind of, yeah, this one is weird. I didn't really plan on this one, so. But right here, it does look completely symmetric, so. Let me see, this is going to be like that. Just one right here, one right here. Skip one, and then on the next one, I put a torch. And on these, I put torches. So now it's fully lit up, and there are kind of really big gaps right here. But as long as I don't really jump up too much, actually, or... Okay, let me just be careful. I don't want to fall down. Well, if I'm going down and I do accidentally jump up, then I might fall down, but I'm not going to do that, and I'm not stupid enough to do that either. Oh, yeah, I'll just have to add one more to make it symmetric right here. So... Okay, the stair area is now all lit up now. Yeah, we're running out of cobblestone wall fast, but we do have a lot of cobblestone, but the lake will take a lot of cobblestone as well, so not something to worry about. And just like I did with that one, this one is gonna go in right here and continue on here. Oh wait, or should it go like that? No, actually, I should grab my pickaxe real quick. Okay, how is it going to go? Oh, actually, no. Yes, this is... Yeah, this is how it's going to go. Now, I'm not really sure how big the lake is going to be. It's going to be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. I don't know. I think it might be... be around that, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Let's just build one more here and then one more there to make it 10, and then go around like that too. 1, 2, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. I know it's a bit overkill, but really, I really want to have an epic lake, just so, well, because I don't really have anything other to do, and, I like a challenge, so I will most likely run out of cobblestone, however, which is the drawback. So, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. And this is just going to be the walkable area, and the lake is actually going to be inside this hole right here. And let me just demonstrate really quick when I reach the other side. So the lake will be the size of this hole right here. That's going to be the whole lake. And I'm planning it to be around, I guess, 5 blocks deep would be a fair representation. And how I'm going to build down, I'm going to use water streams to build down, so... Okay, I hope that's not gonna go in there. Let me just look at it just to make sure. Yep, it's not going to go inside my encasing area, so that's what I'm scared of. Because if the water starts flowing there, then it's going to just destroy all of the pressure plates and most of the torches that I built, and I really hate it because I built the torches so they would be symmetrical to each other. So, let me see. 1, 2, 3, 4. So it's gonna be one, and the reason I only built up 4 is because this block is going to be one block deep as well, so. Okay, I almost ran out of air there. Oh no, I should go just one block down so I can build one right here. Yeah, I hope I don't suffocate right now. Okay, this is going to be the most dangerous area. Okay. Oh, yeah, that was kind of scary. Well, at least I'm safe and sound. Okay, now I'm going to build down. I'm going to build the whole basin, which I will fill up with water, which is actually kind of difficult too. I'm going to go down here. And when I'm actually going to only film the areas where I actually built in the middle of the air, because that's the most interesting thing to show you. And I'm only going to film when I put water in only one block deep, and it's very difficult because you have to destroy a bunch of blocks and then pour water to make sure that there's no like water currents developing within the water. So okay, how am I gonna do this? Okay, so like I said, it's kind of difficult to make sure that there's no water currents inside the water, so and it does take a long time to pour in all the water, and it's a bit boring, so I'm not going to film it. I think I'm only going to film one section. And look, as you can see, the water has already destroyed some of the grass down here. We can see a pattern forming, so I really hope I'm not going to run out of cobble. Oh, I think I'll be fine. Yeah, I should be fine. As long as I don't make it any bigger or anything, I think that I will have enough. Wow, this is going to be a really deep lake. So as you can see, this is 47, and this means that this whole lake will be part of squid spawning territory. So that means we're going to get the maximum amount of squids. I'm also going to use this lake for purposes of fishing and stuff like that, but I'm not actually going to use it to fish for like efficient fishing. I'm only going to use this for kind of like vanilla fishing, and by vanilla I mean fishing without any like redstone applications, or just fishing with your own like with your own eyes. And by that I mean not using an AFK fish farm, because for most of my fishing needs I will definitely make an AFK fish farm and just AFK the heck out of it, because fishing has a lot of very important resources that I do need, such as leather and stuff like that. Okay, let me just put that right here. I'm only going to use this for fishing before I actually make a fish farm, and making a fish farm is actually quite difficult because I actually need hoppers, and for hoppers I'm going to need iron, and for iron I'm either going to need a very huge mob grinder, which is an XP grinder from which I can get iron from zombies, or I could either get some, or I need villagers to make an iron farm, like an iron golem grinder. So yeah, looks like we're gonna have enough cobblestone. We're actually gonna have quite a bit left over too, and I do have much more projects in mind, so that's very great. So now I'm going to show you how I fill in one layer of the lake. Wow, that's really amazing. And think of it, it's just floating in the middle there. So first of all, I'm just thinking, how is this going to be done? Well, first of all, I'm probably going to build up an endless water source here. I'm going to use it for my water needs. I think that the way that it is built is something like this. Well, unfortunately, it is a bit tilted because sometimes I don't really build blocks there. I don't know, if I have time, I might fill in those blocks as well, so I think it's something like this, as far as I know. Yeah, I think it's something like that. I don't really remember exactly how I made it, but I think this is how I make these. Then I'm able to take it from here, place some more right here, and I'm going to have to do this for every layer of the lake, so this will take a long, long time. It's going to be a bit difficult, and not going to be very fun either, so... Okay. Or maybe I should build it... Okay, so maybe I'm going to try a different tactic where I'm just going to destroy all these blocks here just so it'd be faster and maybe fill in a whole row at once. I'm going to see how that works out. I don't know, maybe it's going to work out. I'm pretty sure it is going to work out this way, so let me see. Oh, yep. Oh, it all stabilized, so yeah, this is easier than I expected, so I'm going to place some right over here. Okay, now I can effectively destroy the water right here. And now what I'm going to do is I'm going to destroy these blocks right here. Grab it from this infinite water source right here. And the second layers are going to be a bit more difficult to do since I'll have to account for everything. I just really like how it like levels out and everything, so... Yeah, I'm also kind of running out of pickaxes, but I don't think I will run out anytime soon, so... I think this is where I'm going to end the episode soon, because I'm going to do some off-camera work, including completing this lake. What I might do is... Oh, let me just replace that real quick. What I might do is actually, this might not be the end of the episode. I might actually add another, I might actually cut filming and then... resume filming when I'm actually done with this whole thing, so I think that's what I'm going to do. But if not, this was Minecraft. Like, see everyone in the next episode. I'll try to finish this soon, but if I don't, I will have to carry this out onto the next episode. So I hope you enjoyed this episode, learned something new about Minecraft, about squid spawning, stuff like that. So anyway, see you guys in the next episode, or in this episode, I don't know. So let me just do that really quick, and wow, so beautiful. Hello and welcome back. I have almost completed my, lake, and this is how I made it. So, I just make these kind of, like, blocks right here that go, along the lake right here to build a new layer, and then I go right here, for example, and then I build up right here. I just pour water up here, and then when I pour water here, it becomes an infinite water source. I take one a water bucket from here, and then I place some more right here, and then so on and so forth, and then eventually it becomes a complete layer of water without any flowings. And so I do that with the adjacent water right here, and then I break this block, and they mix together as an infinite water source to create another area of water without any, like, streams. And by streams, I know, and by streams, I mean, like, as you can see, the water here is kind of, like, flowing down there. Well, I actually don't want that with a lake. I want it to look like a natural lake with every block of water and every block inside not being a stream, but being, like, a full block of water. And that's how I do it, so... I'm almost about to complete it, and it's a fairly large lake. It's so deep that it's actually kind of even dark under there. So, like I said before, eventually when I get glowstone, I'm actually planning to put glowstone down there so I can light it up. And as you can see, when they mix together, they just create this, since it's like an infinite water source, it creates this area of water which is completely smooth. And let me just go and pick up some more cobblestone. And it's so dark, I can't even see. So I just have to go and pick up cobblestone all the time. So yeah, this is an amazing lake, and I'm very satisfied that I made it so big. It's going to be very, very beautiful. And as you can see, I also surrounded it by this cobblestone wall area as well. And but for some reason I ran out of torches. I did not bring up enough torches with me, so I'll have to go down and get more torches to complete the pattern here. So this will be very epic, and I'm also gonna have a bunch of glowstone down there lighting it up, and it's gonna be very, very beautiful. So hopefully some squids will spawn. Unfortunately, squids haven't really spawned while I was watching and while I was constructing, but I think they will spawn when I look away, because the squids, they don't really spawn when you look at the water. They just start spawning. Wow. Amazing. They only really start spawning when, like, you don't look. Same as, actually, with mostly all mobs. And so, if my calculations were correct, this whole lake should be a breeding ground for spawning squids. So, wow, that is really epic. That's like the only lake in this whole world. Well, not counting for the lakes and those, not accounting for the small water sources in that well over there and in those plantations over there. This is really the only real lake here. So, and I should be careful jumping up here because I don't want to fall down. So, I'm not really sure if this is going to spawn any squids. Let me just go down here. I can already hear some bats flying down there. My mob grinder. I can hear some cave noises, so. Wow. Oh my god. This is just simply amazing. Like I said before, my hypothesis was correct that they weren't spawning because I didn't look away, so I just ran down there and ran up here again, and there's a ton of squids spawning here, and then I'll have glowstone down there so I could see the squids even better. So I'll just go and kill some, just could get some. Okay, we got some there, right there. Got three. I need more squids. Okay, though, I see best when they're like that. Okay. So I have 5 ink sacks right now. Are there any more? It looks like there's 2 more squids down there. Oh, I can't really see very well. I turned off my lamp just so I could see better. Oh, here's also what I could do. To make it brighter, I could go to video settings and set it to bright. Yes, then that way I can see much better, so I can have some more squid spawning here. I'm also planning, like I said before, I'm planning to put a bunch of more glowstone here, so there we go. I already got 12 ink sacks, so I'm also going to use this for fishing too, and just general stuff like that. I also place a furnace right here. I might add more chests if I start fishing here, but there it goes. Here's our lake. One of my challenges was already completed. I have a set of challenges that I want to complete in this world, or basically for any survival world. So this has been a very fun episode. I think I achieved a lot in this episode. I have never made a squid farm before. Now let me just run down. Let me just go down here. And no, I'm not even going to go down. I'm just going to stay like that and then go out there. Has any squid spawned yet? No, actually, it looks like I do have to run down. Yeah, let me just run down here and then run back up, and there should be a bunch of squids there. Well, it looks like that I actually have to stay there a bit, so this was my Kralix. Thank you very, very much for watching. This is what I've been working for this whole episode. Thank you very, very much for watching. This is my Kralix. Wow, it looks so amazing from here, just a lake floating. Yes, and I can already see some squid there spawning, so anyway, like I said, thank you very, very much for watching. This was Minecraft. See you all in the next video. And if you want me to make a tutorial on this lake that I just made, I could make a tutorial. And I probably will. And we can see them glitching out of there. Wow, that's amazing. There's just so much squids there. So anyway, this is Minecraft, and I'm out.